Hi, it's Von Hertzog. I'd like to welcome you back to the Social Club, my analog digital hybrid studio. Today, I'm going to try and make a shorter video. Some of my videos go long. Some of my last video was like 45 plus minutes. I'm trying to make this one a little shorter, maybe 10, 15 minutes if all goes well. But I want to talk about these guys. I want to talk about these speakers I just built. These use 150 millimeter SEAS Reed Paper Woofers. I paired them with the 22 millimeter aluminum magnesium tweeter, and I think they make a perfect pair. I mentioned in my last video where I went up against AI to see who could build a better speaker on a $500 budget. If you did not see that video, link here. But in that video, when I was doing the part selection, I showed both of these parts that I'm using in this speaker build. Another speaker from SEAS, this is the H1455. This is an 8-ohm speaker, but it has a paper pulp cone. These sound really nice. Big fan of these. I'm thinking about putting them into a design with some speakers down here at the end. And then these little guys here, these are the H1283s. This is a smaller, it's 22 millimeter diaphragm, and very nice Sonamax surround again. Hexagrid again, but a slightly larger hex pattern. These are what I think I'm gonna pair with these Reed paper woofers, because I've done some tests and I liked how it sounded, but I didn't get enough time to really play with them. I'm going to give you the plans, so stick around to the end of the video. You'll be able to build these things out if you want. Right now, the woofers are on sale at Mattisound. They probably won't stay on sale forever, but for right now, you can get these woofers for only 75 bucks a piece. So November 2024, it is currently $75 each for these. When they go up to full price, they're still only 97 a piece. So it's not like you're breaking the bank to get these speakers made, but you're gonna love how they sound. And I wanna talk about why. First things first, I would take these new speakers I built over the AI design speakers any day of the week. Did not like the silk tweeter in those speakers, love the 22 millimeter tweeter in these. By pairing a smaller, you know, 3/4 inch tweeter with a paper woofer, it allowed me to do a couple things. One, it allowed me to push the crossover frequency up to about 3K. Also, I'm used to working on studio monitors here. I had Amphion for 5 years. I had the Amphion 118s. Amphion tries to achieve point source imaging by using a low enough crossover frequency. Essentially, the thought process behind it is when you get the crossover frequency low enough, the distance between the tweeter and the woofer is shorter than the wavelength at the crossover frequency. And what that ends up doing is creating a single point source that they appear to image from. I'm not doing that here. I pushed the crossover up to about 3K. And the reason I did that is that means the majority of the mid-range ends up getting covered by the woofer. If I'm using the Amphions, everything from 1.6 on up, I'm hearing the tweeter and a little bit of that woofer bleed as the crossover rolls off. I'm hearing them both play together. Here, by pushing the crossover frequency higher, I'm hearing more of the woofer across the mid-range. And going with a really good paper woofer for your mid-range is awesome. Again, I'm used to using aluminum woofers and tweeters, and going to this paper one really helped bring out a little bit more of the live sound of it. I would say the aluminum sounds more clinical to me. It sounds like what I'd want out of a studio monitor, where I want something very clinical. These feel more like live music to me. Also, by going to a smaller tweeter, only 22 millimeters instead of say 25 or 27 or even 29 millimeter, by going to a smaller diaphragm, that allows the tweeter to be more nimble. It doesn't have to work as hard, it's lighter. It's slightly smaller, and there tends to be less distortion with it. I paired these things together. I have a very simple crossover. Two coils, two caps, one resistor. That's it. That's the whole crossover for it. Let's take a look at the crossover. I'll show you how I built it out. Okay, so here's the crossover circuit that I'm using on this speaker. It's very basic. We have a 2 millihenry inductor on the low frequency circuit with a 6.8 microfarad capacitor to ground. on the high frequency circuit, we go into a 7.5 ohm resistor, which leads to a 4.7 microfarad cap and a 0.33 millihenry inductor to ground. Not a complicated circuit, has a nice 3000 Hertz crossover point, which makes it very easy to listen to. Could I use these as studio monitors? Sure. I might want to go up to a 7-inch woofer because I feel like the roll-off under 100 Hertz is very smooth. It's a nice smooth roll-off, but I'd like more of a bottom shelf to it. You know what I mean? I'd like a sturdier low end. However, if you're just looking for like some bookshelf speakers, something that you can have in your house, maybe hook up to your TV instead of a sound bar or something, if you want good quality audio, these things are going to do it. And their soundstage is amazing. All of that depth that I was missing from the AI design speaker with the Dayton parts, that's gone. The depth here is wide, it's deep, it sounds beautiful. And I love how these sound. So I want to show you some of the measurements for the speaker. I want to show you the frequency, the distortion, etc. Then you can decide for yourself if you think that this looks like a good pair of speakers, and we can put it out into the world and people can build these if they like. I am not sponsored by Mattisound or SEAS or Parts Express or anyone. All of this is my own opinions going through, so don't worry about that. I am not going to try and get you to buy something so I get rich. I get nothing out of this. But I am trying to share my knowledge and my joy in these speakers. You know, I've listened to them for a couple weeks now, regularly. As you can see, I took down my King RO4Ys and I put these up. I did pair them with the 12-inch subs that I have here in the room. And I can turn the subs on and off. So I listen to them with the subs, I listen to them without the subs. With the subs, they're fantastic. They're full range. It covers everything you need. And there was a nice crossover point I was able to hit at about 150 Hertz that where the sub takes over. Without them, they still work. Again, I'd like a hair more low-end information, but that's the price you pay. Now, you can choose to keep these sealed or ported. If you port, you go with a 1-inch opening, 3 inches deep for the port, and that'll get you down to about 63 Hertz. You could also go with a passive radiator. You have options, you know what I'm saying? So if I want to extend that bass a little bit more without going up to a bigger woofer, I could. I can port the speaker, I can go with a passive radiator. But for now, I like the tight, clean, clear response. So who are these speakers for? Who'd want to listen to these things? Well, I think they're for everybody. Where some speakers, I am more inclined to tell you that they should be studio monitors, that they hi-fi people might not get as much enjoyment out of it. Look, I think there's multiple types of hi-fi people out in the world. I think some hi-fi people just want to listen to their system and whatever's playing through is secondary. They just want to hear back their own purchases. There's other people where the music is the first thing and they just want to hear the recording as faithfully and accurately reproduced as possible. I fall into that category. As a studio engineer, I need to know what is in the recording so nothing hides from me, so I can fix anything, any potential problems before the music's put out into the world and audiophiles start picking it apart. I try and get those things out of the way ahead of time. So if you want, you can pair these with your sub and they're going to make a nice full range speaker for you. Without a sub, still great. Still have that low end extension. Now again, it rolls off, so the lower it gets, the softer it gets, but it's a nice, very smooth roll off. You can see in the measurement, I stitched in at 300 Hertz on down, so it's a nice smooth roll off, and everything above that is the speaker measured here in the room. I took these measurements from a distance of 1 meter. You can see here when I put the overlay over that we're within plus or minus 2 decibels from 100 Hertz all the way to 20K. So it's a really nice smooth speaker. It has some liveliness to it and it sounds great in your room. I have the impedance measurement here. Let's look at it all and see what it's telling us. Okay. Okay, you might be able to hear Ralph snoring, but here's the impedance graph for this speaker. As you can see, very easy to drive. 8 ohm speaker, the lowest it ever dips down is 7 ohms. 8 ohms nominal load, very easy to drive. Enough said. Good snore, Ralph. But now that I have them set up here and I've been listening to them, I have to tell you, I love how natural these things sound. Where the aluminum woofers tend to make it feel a bit more sterile and more like you're hearing a reproduction of exactly what was recorded, these give a bit more of a live music feeling. I don't know why. I notice it a lot more with rock songs, like, you know, One Headlight by the Wallflowers. That is one of my reference songs that I like to listen to, because what I love about One Headlight by the Wallflowers is when you sit there, you sit in the sweet spot, you close your eyes, and you hear the instruments start to appear on the soundstage in front of you. And it sounds like they're right there. You hear the guitar, you hear the bass, you hear the organ, you hear the drums, and then his voice comes dead center. Everything about that sounds like an amazing live performance, like you're sitting there in front of it. When I listen on aluminum woofers, sometimes everything sounds crystal clear and it almost sounds more holographic, as where these sound holographic in their projection of space, but they sound more natural and live, like if you were in the room listening to live music. And that's why I think these are going to be a hit with hi-fi people. But if you want to build them, just do it. Same as in my AI video, I created a spreadsheet. All the parts for the speakers are listed in the spreadsheet. You can build them out yourself if you're so inclined. Order what you need. Woofer and tweeter from Mattisound. I think everything else from Parts Express. I love them. Like I was saying, they sound a little bit more natural than the aluminum woofers. Again, going back to a non-active speaker with passive parts, there is something slightly different to me. You know, I know that on paper, active speakers should always be the better speaker, right? But in my personal experience, I have heard plenty of passive speakers that sound better than active speakers. So I always hate that comparison when people show up in the comments and they're like, well, you know, a active speaker would always sound better and less parts in the... Cool, bro. Cool. Not this time. Not in this experience. So listening to music on these things, what do they sound like? Like I said, One Headlight, big, beautiful. Adia, beautiful. Her voice, the natural airiness in her voice at the beginning of the single mix of Adia. Beautiful. I listen to hip hop on it. Can you listen to hip hop on it? Yeah. The bass response is not strong, but it is there. And you hear the bass notes very cleanly. This is a very low distortion speaker. I will show you the distortion stats. As you can see, the distortion on these are 50 dB down. Like, it's a non-factor. Here, you can really hear the program material without the distortion getting in the way. At no point does this speaker become obnoxious. It always behaves nicely and sounds nice. They have some kick to them too. They have a decent X-Max on them, so you can get some air moving, even though they're smaller woofers. Would I recommend you building these out? Yes, absolutely. I would recommend these highly because I think they sound really good. And I've listened to a bunch of music. The detail in the mid-range is spectacular. Really hearing a lot of texture and detail in some hip-hop samples. You know, when I'm listening back to like 90s hip-hop where they did a lot of sampling, the texture in the samples, sometimes the record crackle and everything, is so clear and present. It amazes me. I think by sticking with a smaller woofer and a smaller diaphragm tweeter, that's why these speakers can shine the way they do. Having that woofer cover more of that mid-range and only having the tweeter really be responsible for the highs and the very top part of the mid-range is fantastic. You're not asking the tweeter to do a whole lot extra. You're using the smaller diaphragm so it has the agility and nimbleness it needs to recreate the sounds even clearer. Like I said, I want to keep this video short. I don't want to run too long on it, so I'm not going to talk forever about it. But I did want to cover how I feel about these speakers. You know, to me, they're too good not to share. So I want to share with you guys. And if you want to go out and build them, awesome. If you do, drop me a line and tell me what you thought about it. I would love to hear what your impression is of these speakers once you get them built out. And if you're saying to yourself, oh man, those speakers are awesome, but I'm not the best at building these things. You know, I don't really have that DIY knack that some people do. That's cool. Hit me up. I'll build these out for you if you want. You know what I'm saying? I can build these speakers for you. I have the design all ready to go. If you want me to do it, hit me up. So I think the build total came to like $467, right around there. We can discuss the money, what the build price is, because I'm not 100% sure, depending on what finishes you go with, etc. But hit me up. It's not going to be a ton of money. I'll charge you fairly for my time. Send me an email, comment here. There's a variety of ways to do it. You can hit me up at inclinedfidelity@gmail.com. Me and Vince are still building speakers. We're doing speakers in batches now. Initially, we built out what our product line is. You know, we have the VH180s, we have the SVH7S, and we have some smaller versions of those speakers as well. But we decided from a business standpoint to move to a MTO plan where you order, you can customize the speaker exactly how you want, and then we will build it out and ship it to you. There are lots of potential upgrades and choices when you're building a speaker, the type of crossover parts you use, the finish for the speaker itself. All of those things play into the price and the amount of time it takes to build a speaker out. So all of those things affect the price. However, I'm not looking to get rich building you a pair of speakers. I'm just looking to be fairly compensated for my time. So if it's something you're interested in, hit me up. If it's not, no offense. I wish you all the luck building it on your own. And I've even included all the parts you need for the know-how. I love these things. I'm going to keep listening to them. You know, I might move them into my living room to be my main speakers with my television. I'm not 100% sure now, but I really do love how these things sound. But I don't know if I want to move them out of my studio because I do love doing critical listening on these things. I love pulling up my Tidal playlist of all my favorite songs for speaker testing and just going through and listening. Really good speakers. I hope you enjoy them. You want me to build them out, hit me up. And don't forget to check out inclinedfidelity.com. Like I said, we have moved to a made-to-order system. So if you are interested in an SVH7S, or you're interested in a VH180, or you're interested in the King RO4Y MK3s, we're building them all. But we're not just building them to have a stock built up in a warehouse we don't own. So let us know what you want. We'll build them out specifically for you. So you get to make all the choices. But for the past few years, we've been regularly churning out speakers, selling them to very happy customers. I think I need to do some testimonials soon where I get people who actually own these speakers to talk about them, because a lot of people say they don't like hearing me talk about speakers I've built because they feel I'm trying to sell them something. And again, I am trying to give you the information to do this yourself. If you want to hire me, you can, because I do know what I'm doing. But I'm not trying to separate you and your money. I'm just trying to give you potential options. If you're not handy, you can hire us. If you are handy, go for it on your own. And I'm still here for questions if you need. And I hope that does it. As always, thank you for watching my videos. If you don't already like and subscribe, please do. Helps out a lot. Helps with the channel. I'm trying to grow this channel. I just passed 4,000 subscribers. It's by no means gaudy numbers, but I'm still proud of every last one. And I hope that I can count you as one of my subscribers. If not, hit that button so then I can. And welcome to the social club. We love audio here. And all we want to do is discuss speakers and studio engineering and just audio in general, because it's what we love. It's what we love to do. And why not share that passion with you? Because I know you love it too. That's why you're here. That's why you're watching that video. So thank you. Thank you for coming along. Thank you for watching. Thank you for liking and subscribing. Thank you for commenting. And if you do end up building these things out, I want to know about it. I want you to drop me a line and tell me exactly what you think. And if you're interested in having me build this out for you, hit me up as well. I'll be happy to do it. Small fee. I saw Randy at Cheap Audio Man had done this before, and I guess he had ended up building pairs of speakers out for people. Look, I can do the same thing over here, you know, except these are my designs. He was building other people's kits. These are my designs, and I'm happy with them. I wouldn't be putting them out into the world if I didn't think that they sounded really, really good. So I hope you got something out of this. And if you did, please come back for the next video. So until next time, this has been Von Hertzog from the Social Club.